All right, let's get pumped, people. So we were talking about chanting earlier, and I want to start a little march-style chant for our next presenter to let him know how much we love him. So when I say Martin, you say, holy crap, there's no way she's actually talking about one of the greatest filmmakers of all time, Martin Scorsese. That would be awesome. Wait, no, really? Huh? Okay, so here we go. Martin! That was so good. That was so good. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Martin Scorsese.
Thank you. Whew. Wow. Thank you. Whoa. Thank you. So they took the 16 millimeter A and B rolls, and they made a terrible mistake in the cutting of those negatives. Now, this was my first film, was a short, and the negative was in effect ruined, right? And like, we had a deadline of 48 hours to get a print made of the film to show at the class presentation. I was in despair. It really was a disaster. But our professor was named Haig Manoogian at NYU. And he grabbed this other student from the class and he said, she can do it. She can restore the negative and get a print made in time. And she did it. She did this meticulous work for about 40 hours straight, no sleep. And the picture was shown at the presentation. Actually, the picture got me a small scholarship to continue at NYU. And Thelma and I have become friends. We became friends and co-workers for the next 6 years. We worked together on documentaries and all sorts of things, and including my first feature, which took about 3 or 4 years to make on and off like a hobby, was called Who's That Knocking? And by 1970, we sort of went off and pursued different paths during the decade of the 70s. But by 79, I was able to persuade her back to take on the role of editor of the movie I was making, Raging Bull. Now, we worked together ever since then for over 37 years. I mean, since that time, she's won 3 Oscars and like a lot of nominations. I forget how many. Now, I love the editing the most of the filmmaking process. And a lot of it really has to do with spending time with Thelma. Because when we make a picture, we live immersed in the film's universe. And sometimes it's not always a pleasant place to be. And each film really becomes like a lifetime, and each film becomes a great adventure, and we share that adventure together. So we spent many lifetimes together. And I've been asked over the years, how do you guys work together? Could we do an article on you? Could we watch you guys work and everything? I mean, you know, people try, and we try to explain. We learned rapidly that there's no sense in that. People, you can't explain it. It's what we do, and it's pretty much nobody's business. But I must say, ultimately, it's about trust. It's the trust in her and her fierceness to protect and fight tenaciously for the truth of the film. And the support she provides, usually under the worst of circumstances. And that support makes it possible for me to make the film that I started out trying to make. When we did Raging Bull in 1980, she met a friend of mine, Michael Powell, who was the great filmmaker from England. And Thelma and Michael married, had a wonderful marriage and a wonderful life together. They still do have a wonderful life together, because all these past years, she has dedicated and devoted herself. I'm dedicated, devoted, like abstract words. What that means is that her tireless action had made it possible for the legacy of Michael Powell and the co-filmmaker he was with, Emmerich Pressburger, to thrive and live again for film lovers and generations to come for as long as possible. Now, that same meticulous, untiring care she displayed in that broken negative in 1963, she retains and supersedes, really, with her work on Powell's films. Her restoration of the classic film, The Red Shoes, by Powell and Pressburger, alone deserves this award. And so we have some clips here now.
Every night, man.
Yeah, but get yourself a girl so you can settle down. That's what I mean.
I settle down almost every night, but then in the morning I'm free. I love you.
I'm funny how? I mean, funny like I'm a clown. I amuse you.
Pull back on the wheel a smidge.
Go, Lee!
Let's do something crazy tonight.
You know, for one night, I'd like to see myself out of my head. Wouldn't you like to see me out of my head? Wouldn't that be great? Wouldn't that be fabulous?
Paradise Square.
Weapons?
That I leave up to you.
Bricks, bats, axes, knives. Pistols?
No pistols.
Good boy.
Thank you. a boy on the track! Get out of the way! It's a boy!
So, to Thelma with Love, I have the honor of presenting the ACE Career Achievement Honor for you tonight. So, Thelma.
Thank you so much. I have a bad case of laryngitis, but I'm not Meryl Streep. So I did. Marty's pretty much said my whole speech, but I'm still going to say a large part of it. It means so much to me to get this from you, my fellow editors. But the award belongs as much to Marty as to me. For without the 23 films, this utterly, utterly brilliant director has made that I have helped him edit, I would not be thanking you. Marty's favorite part of filmmaking is editing, and he thinks like an editor when he conceives of a film, when he co-writes it, and particularly when he shoots it. You know what it means to receive footage that has been shot with editing in mind. It is a blessing. So, he's already said, by a great stroke of accident and fate, I met him. But even back then at NYU, we knew he had it. He had what it would take to become a great director. That was very clear in his student films. Thankfully, because I helped him repair his negative, he diverted me from what I thought I wanted to do, which was enter the Foreign Service, and set about teaching me to edit. I knew nothing about editing when I met him, nothing. And I am still learning from him every day. We cut all of his films together, and that's why I mean this as his award as much as it is as mine. As we move from student and teacher to become collaborators in the editing room, I've been so incredibly lucky that he has let me accompany him as he sets himself new challenges with each film he makes. I get to help him meet those challenges. I can't begin to tell you how thrilling that is. Think how different Shutter Island is from Hugo, how Hugo is so different from Wolf of Wall Street, and how startling different Wolf is from Silence. Each film requires a change in editing style and stretches us both. I'm sure some of you are envious of the rich ferment of creativity that goes on in the editing room. As we edit, we talk about art, history, religion, politics, many things. I am privileged to witness the swings of emotion Marty goes through during the editing of a film. It's fascinating, I can tell you. He's also infected me with his passion for film history, and we always have an additional monitor in the editing room where Turner Classic Movies is playing. But not in our direct eye line. and with the sound turned off, of course. Marty will sometimes glance over at a classic film and say, look, look, this director is about to make a great camera move, or watch what this actor is just going to do. It's like being in the best film history course in the world. When he was educating me about the films of the British filmmakers Michael Powell and Emmerich Pressburger, he introduced me to another genius, the director Michael Powell. We fell in love and married, as Marty has said, which gave me the 10 happiest years of my life. And having Michael Powell, whom Marty revered, around us while we were making films was a dream. He had gone to England to find Powell and Pressburger, and he almost single-handedly resurrected their work and brought it back to the world, which has just been fantastic. After Michael died, Marty devoted his film foundation to restoring three of the beautiful Technicolor masterpieces that Powell and Pressburger made, and I'm so endlessly grateful to him. And I'm very happy that tonight Ned Price from Warner Brothers, who did those three masterful restorations, is here. I hope we can encourage young filmmakers to do what Marty did, learn how to become filmmakers by studying the great films of the last century. As you can see, I've had all the luck anyone can want in my life, and I still can't believe that at my greatly advanced age, I am working on such groundbreaking films as Marty's new film, Silence. And I can't wait for the next one to start. I'd like to thank Scott Brock, my associate editor, who has been with us for 23 years. And who somehow has gotten me through sleepless nights before screenings, helping me do temp mixes and a million other things, always with utter devotion and creativity. I could never have done it without him. I think we editors have the best job in the world, and I wish I could cut up all the luck I have had to put in little packages on each of your tables tonight. But mostly, I would like to thank Marty and the mysterious art of editing, giving me a wonderful life. Thank you.